But expectations are really the most important part of negotiation. We all go into negotiations with wishes, numbers in our head. These are things that we want, but they're literally wishes. And then we also have our expectations. So I gave this example about my niece, Rachel, who I asked her, she was about to start a college class. And I said, Rachel, what's the highest grade you might get in this college, in this semester? And she said, Tony, I think I might get an A. That was her best case scenario. And I said, what's your worst case scenario? What's the lowest grade you might get? And she said, C. And then I asked her a third question, the most important question there is when it comes to negotiation. I said, Rachel, what grade do you expect to get? And she said, a B. And what grade did she wind up getting at the end of the semester? Well, she got a B. So in negotiation, we get what we expect. In life, we get what we expect as well. So a skilled negotiator understands that before you ever talk numbers with somebody, you've got to shape their expectations. That's where tactics come into play. So we always want the other party aiming low in a negotiation. We don't want the other party ever thinking that they're going to do really well. We don't want their expectations growing. We want their expectations diminishing.